Happy Valentine's! In this Valentine, I have a very special gift for you, an exclusive story online for the first time that will definitely blow your mind away. I'm about to take you on a journey a few years ago with my partner. I got to know through some work friends that she made two statements at two different times, and two people delivered this statement to me. She said, "If he doesn't blow my mind away this Valentine, that will be the end of this relationship." When I got to know this information, I said, "All right, battle is on. I accept the challenge. However, I might have a surprise for you." The team of three that made the impossible possible. She wanted, and we delivered. Welcome back to Creating Your Own New Limitless World. And for the new faces, I am Dr. Joe Isaac. If you want to find out a little bit more about me and my purpose, I will put all the details in the video description below. I am very passionate about helping people level up their game and feel super excellent about themselves. So the first thing that I have done is I looked up the size of the biggest Valentine's card as per Guinness records, and I decided I'm gonna beat it. The second thing that was on plate, she wanted to have a meal at dinner time exactly where the sun sets. The problem with this place, which I will show you exactly where, is this: that the sun sets on a public place. There is no restaurants around there where you can have that five-star dining experience that she has always dreamed of. The third thing is our moments, the very, very special moments, to be recollected in a particular frame from all the travels and all the memories of the years. So after looking up Guinness Records, most biggest Valentine's card, I realized it's not possible to go and buy that from the shop. So I decided I'm gonna have a plan and I'm going to manufacture one. In this plan, I had my amazing flatmate that was going to help me execute few strategies, and the third person, which will be revealed in the story later on. I went and I purchased multiple numerous red A4 pages, kind of card that is enforced. Then I cut each part of those pages into three pieces. Upon manufacturing the card, I then had to punch holes into the four corners of every third of the page. Let's call this a card. And punching those holes, I had to feed them through a fishing line with multiple rolls to be able to feed that through, so I can always fold the card on top of each other. And once it's set on the floor or hanged on a building, that's when it's all gonna be straight. On each piece, I decided to write my own poetry. And that is the first item, manufacturing the biggest, the largest, most enormous Valentine's card in the world that I haven't registered in Guinness Records. The second piece, where she wanted to dine, this place in Australia called Coogee. This is the only place when she can see that exact view that she wanted when the sun sets and the dinner time. And in that corner, the only place available to do this is public place where pergolas are. So I had a plan with another person that came in to assist. The plan had to be timed perfectly and no expectation at all. So we had to make sure that we're there at the right time, exactly where the sun sets, and dinner is served five stars by a professional chef in their uniform. So I called my partner and I told her to dress up for dinner and that I have a surprise for her. I went then, I picked her up, and I told her that the surprise is so amazing that I don't want her to see anything. So I'm gonna blindfold her until I will unleash the surprise. Picked her up, had the call with the professional chef waiting for the call. Stopped the car in the middle. She was blindfolded. She doesn't know what is exactly going on. And I told him she's gonna grab something from the booth. I went outside to grab something from the booth. And in that time, I opened the back door where the chef sat down with all the food that was already semi-prepared to be served five stars in a public place. Then we drove all the way to Coogee, and exactly at the time when I arrived there, there were so many people, it was so busy. I had to talk to the people to see if someone is happy to spare me that space so I can set up the five stars experience with the chef while my partner at the time is in the car, still blindfolded. So I got out of the car quickly and I opened the door for the chef. All this time, she doesn't know that there is someone else is in the car, and got all the food out. And then I had to go into negotiations with the people over there at the pergolas to try to pay them out so they can leave the space so we can dress it and cover it up and prepare for five stars experience in a park in Coogee. I was very successful to manage to get the people to leave the place for us and to set up, helping the chef set everything up, dressing the tables and preparing preparing everything with the candles. The dinner was ready to be served exactly at the sunset time. So I went back to the car and I grabbed her. She's still blindfolded. And I asked her, "Do you think where you are?" She had no idea. And then after unleashing that blindfold, it was exactly there at the time where the dinner is ready to be served with the chef, 5 stars, and exactly at sunset. On that dinner table, I've also done a couple of other surprises. On the wine glasses, I have drawn with my own hand some art for it with the Valentines. And I have also decorated a whole entire bottle with chocolates. And I made everything exactly personal for the occasion and with her name. All this experience, she hasn't seen the Valentine's card yet. That's when my flatmate comes into the picture. He was on a phone call, ready. When I say I'm coming, I have trained them how to get the Valentine's card open and distribute it along the whole entire floor so it can actually fit. After she was very happy with the dinner, we headed to the house, and this is where the next surprise was. And she had no idea that that will be prepared, and she didn't know that I was making a phone call to my flatmate to prepare the card. So when she enters, she faces the largest Valentine's card in the world at the time. As she finished reading the poetry that I have written, I then hit her with the very next surprise, which is a short video of all the moments that she has always loved and always admired and commented on, all in one piece just for her. The experience that she went through is something that she has never experienced before. When she went to work, I got the information from my sources that she was absolutely blown. But the problem I have here is when this relationship was put on a tangle that if he doesn't, then I will. That was the mistake that I called the unforgivable mistake. If you are putting conditions on a relationship you are in, this is already alarming, and it's something that I would not take lightly. So at that time, I realized this is not the right person for me. So the moral of the story is, if you have a partner that is putting conditions on a relationship for whatever reason it is, you might have to rethink twice if you want to make this Valentine's Day very special for you. The first thing that you want to look for is you are with the right person that has got the right characteristics that you can share the journey forward, not someone that links everything with conditions, because this person, no matter what you do, they will never ever be pleased.